Hi guys, welcome back. Today I am going to be talking about something that has been bothering me ever since Mark Zuckerberg announced Meta and introduced the metaverse to me. I want to express the dread that I felt knowing that I was right and my parents were wrong. I was raised with the ideology that you must finish school, get a job or study and find a job and keep that job until you die. You must work with your hands and you are not allowed to do anything creative as a career. So, I eventually gave up arguing with my parents and submitted to getting a degree and finding a normal job. I finally finished my degree and will finish the attached obligations this year. Thereafter I'll be unemployed. I prefer to look at it as a forced permanent vacation, in order not to lose hope. And it's not just me that will be jobless come January 2022, but most of the class of 2019 alongside me. Press F in the comments to pay respect to the members of the class of 2019 that are about to be unemployed. I'd like to point out that my degree is one that is in high demand, but with this economy. The irony is most of us were put on this path by our parents in order to not be jobless, but here we are. It's funny, isn't it? Technology is advancing rapidly and you must try your best to keep up, but it will become impossible. In the near future, technology will advance so fast that we reach the singularity, a point of no return. Every second that goes by you will be left further and further behind. This can already be seen, even with the current technology we have. Does anyone know how a TV works exactly? But seriously, many jobs are going to die out and the rate at which it does will increase over time until the only jobs left are those that require interpersonal human contact. I wanted to keep up and understand technology, but my parents forbade it. We are moving in the direction of technological dependence, and I am so far behind because of my culture's ideologies that I fear never being able to catch up. I listened to Mark Zuckerberg talk about the components of the metaverse and decided I need to get on board the train. I believed the easiest way to do that would be to join YouTube and start creating new content. Not only is this a new hobby to keep my mind and eye busy in the coming unemployment, but it is also a great way to catch up to the rest of society in a desperate attempt to not be left behind. If only there was some way to gain this knowledge in a fun and interactive way. Oh yeah, that brings me to today's sponsor. Skillshare. I'm joking. I need to stop doing that. It's probably not funny anymore. Moving on. I realize now that my wording was wrong when I argued with my parents all those years ago. I never wanted to explicitly do this as a career, but rather as a hobby. I wanted to play video games, make videos, paintings, and sculptures as a kid, as an after-school activity. But I was told to stop fooling around and study. This makes me angry at myself for not trying harder to convince my parents to allow me to be creative. No parent has ever forbidden a child to participate in sport, called sport a waste of time and a distraction from studying. But being an artist has never gotten this level of love. If artists got the same level of love as professional athletes, there would be no World War II. This hobby being taken away from me was a bad idea. Now I have high levels of stress with a job, and soon I'll be jobless with high levels of stress. Hobbies are there to keep your mind busy and distract you from the existential dread that is reality. I don't have that. I never had that. If more parents encouraged their children to be creative, we would probably have a suicide rate of zero, but they don't, so we don't. Imagine a glass cup filled with water up to just about under halfway. This represents your life being in perfect balance, but life will throw problems at you, represented as oil being poured into the glass of water. It is then your job to empty out the oil before it becomes too much, but some people use substances because they cannot cope with the problems. These substances are represented as alcohol being poured into the heterogeneous mix of oil and water in an attempt to solve the problems. The alcohol merely dissolves it, but eventually the alcohol evaporates and the mixture separates. Now you still have to get rid of the existing problems, along with any extra problems life threw at you in the meantime. This makes the glass overflow with oil and you become consumed by substance abuse while your entire life falls apart, and this is in most cases unreversible. But it could all have been prevented had the person been allowed to be creative. Creativity as a hobby in this analogy can be represented as putting a lid over the glass so that the oil can't get in. Anyway guys, I think that I'm going to end it here. Let me know what you think of my views on this topic in the comments down below. And as always, thank you for spending some time here today. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Have a great day.